Hello and welcome. This session is how data drives resilient and sustainable supply chains. My name is Hans Thalbauer. I'm the Managing Director for Supply Chain and Logistics Solution here at Google Cloud. I will be joined by Dave Ingram, the Chief Procurement Officer at Unilever, a little bit later during the show. But let's jump into the topic. It's about global supply chains and the distress of the supply chains. We all have seen that. There are so many aspects which have been presented and written about in the news, in the Financial Times, the Wall Street Journal, and, right? I think there's not a specific area in the world, or there are not specific products or companies which were not impacted by all this distress. What is the distress I'm talking about? It's disruptions, right? So it's really supply chain disruptions. Is it a ship stuck in the Suez Canal, or is it about climate change? Is it about disruption through weather and extreme weather, the hurricanes, the typhoons, the storms, and so on? So a lot of distress going on, and it really, really disrupts supply chains. We see that impact not only in one industry, we see the impact in all the industries. When you think about manufacturing industries, it's really an issue right now with microchips, right? So a shortage of microchips. And the shortage of microchips is leading to, in the automotive industry, to really have plants shut down and really delaying actually the production processes. Big issue. The second one, the retail and consumer products industries. Here we see, for example, right now, a truck driver shortage. Probably you've seen the news out of the United Kingdom that there are about 100,000 truck drivers missing. And you see already empty shelves in the retail stores. In life science industries, we are all aware about the distribution of vaccines and all the issues around that. And in transportation and logistics, there's not a single day when you don't hear any other news which are really slowing down actually transportation processes. Is it a container shortage, or is it really about the COVID-19 outbreak at a specific port, which is then shutting down the port and. So disruptions everywhere in all the different industries, and it gives a big headache to every supply chain professionals in the world. Why is this important to understand? Because all what we are aiming for is building a more resilient and a more sustainable supply chain for the future. This should not be just a buzzword, right? We really need to think about these concepts more in detail. We need to understand how we can actually really build this resilient and sustainable supply chain. We are thinking about three main categories of processes here. It's about the supply chain design, it's about the supply chain visibility, it's about supply chain operations. When we think about design here, it's really important to understand that during the product innovation process, right, so the engineering process or the R&D process, this is the crucial one. This is where engineers and scientists decide which ingredients or components are being used in the finished product. Right? With this decision, these engineers and scientists decide actually 80% of the supply chain itself. So it's all about the cost in the supply chain, which is predetermined at this point in time. Why is that? Because you decide who is actually my supplier for these components. What kind of products do I source from which location? And this is the important actually aspect to understand. And it's not just 80% of the cost of the supply chain, which is predetermined at this stage. It's also about the sustainability aspect. 80% of the carbon footprint is probably predetermined at this point in time as well. So very crucial process when you design products or change the design of a product. The second aspect is really about the supply chain visibility. Here it's all about track and trace, and it's about analytics and reporting. And tracking and tracing means I need to understand where are the products, how much inventory do I have, is everything on track? And also I need to analyze and report on this. And finally, it's about the operations, the execution processes. What if I could actually predict the risk which are involved, all the weather extremes and other aspects? What if I could consider that much better in my supply chain model, right? So this is the question which we need to answer in the operation side. So to build a resilient, sustainable supply chain, keeping design, visibility, and operations in sync is the key. And of course, in order to do that, data plays a critical role. Actually, it's really a fundamental aspect we are talking about here. Right? So data plays the foundation and builds the foundation for all of this. If you think about it, we need to build an end-to-end supply chain model. When I say that, I mean, it's not just the view of the enterprise and all the locations of the enterprise. It's also the locations of the business partners, the suppliers, not just tier one, but really think about the end-to-end model from the raw material down to the customer. Also include all the business partners from the logistics side, but also from the manufacturing side. If you do that, then we have a supply chain model. Now we actually really can talk about building visibility in the supply chain. This allows us to monitor the risk, not only for one entity, but for end-to-end supply chain, to monitor the sustainability impact in terms of carbon footprint or broader in terms of the greenhouse gas emissions. And it enables us to really leverage artificial intelligence, machine learning processes much, much better to predict risk and sustainability impacts. Now let's hear from Dave Ingram at Unilever, the Chief Procurement Officer at Unilever, who talks about the impact of data and how to create a sustainable supply chain.
How has the combination of Google Earth and cloud computing supported Unilever in its deforestation agenda?
Yeah, so this has been really fundamental, particularly the last 18 months of our partnership and work with Google. We buy just under a million tons, let's say, of palm oil in some derivative way from multiple sources. So the data, visibility of data, as I mentioned, is difficult. And our speed of processing that data has been a major constraint. So the work with Google Cloud and Google Earth Engine is about processing that faster and actioning it and giving our buyers and sustainability teams better information faster. So you bring all these data sets together, processing and speed, and you're delivering them in a way that our people inside the business can actually work with. They can take sourcing decisions based on that data. We like to call that our command center because it centralizes and processes all those inputs, actual movements with deforestation data, with biodiversity data. And it gives us, our teams, an unprecedented view of what they're sourcing, where from, and what the risk and impact is of that sourcing. So then we can make choices. By making sense of that data, we can make choices about from where and whom we're sourcing. Also improves our partnerships with our suppliers, because we can be much more directive and clear about where we want to source from. It really helps prevent deforestation from happening the faster we get that data. So it really has been fundamental these last 18 months of work with yourselves.
Benefiting the wider value chain.
Yeah, look, I mentioned for ourselves, if I remain inside Unilever for a moment, palm is a complex supply chain, but equally the technology is translatable to soy in Latin America, North America is translatable to tea in many parts of Africa and India. So within Unilever, it's scalable, but of course it's scalable across the whole industry. And that's where the simplifying of really complex data sets becomes critical to increasing that transparency across the industry, across the supply chain, but across all peers, and actually enables collaboration across these partnerships, whether they be public or private. We know that tackling deforestation can be achieved on our own. It does take collective action from companies like us, of course, but also our suppliers, NGOs, local civic societies, and peer groups. And having a common information set is really critical to generate that change.
Thank you, Dave. Now let's talk about what Google is providing and how Google is actually thinking about solutions in order to address these problems. We are introducing this digital supply chain platform, and this platform has four main pillars. The first pillar is all about the supply chain twin, the digital twin of the supply chain, right? It's a digital representation of the physical supply chain. What we are talking about is really mapping all the different locations, bringing in data from the enterprise, which we call the private segment, which is really the forecast information, the demand information, the orders, and so on. But then we combine it with the collaboration information. So about the communities with your business partners, the information which is being shared between the business partners. And The third aspect is all about the public segment. So information which is available publicly, which would be weather information, which would be traffic information, risk management information, sustainability information, market trends, and. If we do that, then we create really the full visibility which is needed in order to run the supply chain. It's not just the enterprise data. You need to bring in the collaboration data and the community data, and you need to combine it with the environment, with the context. And if we have enabled that, now we can really see what's going on in the supply chain. The second pillar is all about the supply chain pulse. So how we provide access to this information, how supply chain professionals are able to access this information. And here it's all about analytics, the communication, collaboration tools. And for Google, this means we are talking about Looker and also Google Workspace, how we realize this access to this information. The third pillar is all about the supply chain simulation and optimization. Here we leverage artificial intelligence and machine learning algorithms. We do that in the context of end-to-end business processes. The first one being demand shaping. So really thinking about the market trends, the segmentation of customers, and the forecasting processes. The second end-to-end process is really about inventory positioning. So where do I put inventory? In a multi-mode and multi-echelon supply chain. The third end-to-end process is around perfect fulfillment. It's about the warehouse management and transportation processes. And the fourth and final end-to-end process is really about building a resilient and sustainable supply chain. So thinking about risk management and the different categories of risk, and thinking about sustainability, and not only about the greenhouse gas emissions, but also about the circular economy aspect, also about the social responsibility aspects. The fourth pillar of this strategy is all about supply chain partners. It's not only Google which provides all this information. We are working together here with a broad ecosystem, and we work with data providers, we work with application partners, and we work with system integrators. So broad ecosystem in order to realize this vision of the supply chain platform and really to address the biggest problems in the world of providing visibility in the supply chain to run supply chains much better. The solutions which we just brought to the market this year are about supply chain twin and supply chain pulse. The supply chain twin, as I mentioned, is really about organizing and orchestrating the supply chain data. And the supply chain pulse is about providing access to this information for the supply chain professionals. Now let's look at these two solutions. And I would ask to the colleagues, Ashwin and Chris, to really provide this demonstration.
Hi, I'm Ashwin Sridhar, Industry Solutions Architect working on supply chain and logistics. Today, I'm going to talk to you about supply chain twin and supply chain pulse. Supply chains today are complex networks with interdependencies across business units, geographies, and partners. Making sense of this complexity can mean the difference between a company being at the mercy of disruptions or taking control and having the ability to win in the market. Supply chain twin and supply chain pulse enable businesses to take advantage of data insights to gain transparency, as well as be able to plan scenarios in order to mitigate risk. This will allow you to understand demand better, have your products in the right place at the right time, deliver as expected, and accomplish all of this while maintaining your sustainability goals and impact. At the heart of the solution is BigQuery, Google Cloud's serverless, massively scalable data platform. To that, we add the ability to seamlessly connect to and collect data from your business systems, forming the basis of the private segment of your data model, the ability to share data bidirectionally and securely with your partners, forming the basis of the community segment of your data model, and third, the ability to incorporate and understand the impact of contextual data to your supply chain, forming the basis of the public segment of your data model. The supply chain twin brings data across all these segments, private, community, and public, into a unified linked data model to provide an end-to-end view of the entire physical supply chain to unlock powerful capabilities. Let's take a look at an example of this in action.
Ashwin has introduced the power of the supply chain twin. Next, we will look at how the business user can leverage this power. Supply Chain Pulse will enable you to seamlessly interact with your supply chain data and allow your teams to drive business decisions supported by AI. Pulse empowers you to visualize real-time end-to-end model data and activate work streams based on insights. Supply Chain Pulse is created with an awareness of your supply chain complexity, empowering users to drill down on their geography, business unit, or product, and connect with internal and external partners to ensure that issues are resolved. For this demo, we will be following Alice's user journey. Alice is the director of supply chain at a global manufacturer. Alice starts her day by calling her personalized alerts in Supply Chain Pulse. Today, she sees an alert for supply chain risk of a key component, component 301. Alice will need more information to understand the risk, so she triggers the alert deep dive view. Powered by Looker, the alert deep dive interface brings together the relevant information Alice needs to act on this issue, filtered automatically for component 301. Alice starts by leveraging public data sets to look at global demand. Because the data set is across all demand sources, Alice can see the bigger picture, not just the situation for her company or sector. She sees that while her own sector demand is stable, overall consumption is going up. Next, she leverages the community data set to look at recent changes in inventory position for C301 at her top suppliers. This is an example of data collaboration in BigQuery between trusted members within the supply chain. Recent data for her supply chain partner shows that inventory levels are decreasing. Alex then consults the trend for procurement lead time across markets for C301 and sees that they are slowly rising. She also sees that internally, the balance of inventory at the US warehouses has substantial variance, likely because there was no scarcity for that component previously. All signs point to risk for this component, but Alice wants to call on a second opinion for exactly how to react to this situation. Here's where Pulse's capacity to pass a snapshot of the supply chain twin to the optimization AI comes into play. Alice will pass over the relevant data to the inventory positioning solver. The AI engine will recommend the appropriate increase in safety stock, as well as sever inter-warehouse transfers. These results are visualized in Looker so Alice can validate the results along with her team. To shape her solution, Alice has leveraged multiple components of supply chain twin and Pulse. She started with the real-time alert in Pulse, then drilled into her company's internal data, community data from key supply chain partners, and market trends from public data sets to understand the holistic picture for component-level risk. Lastly, she called on the AI solver to optimize her tactical response. In a situation such as this, longer-term solutions may include expanding the supplier base or exploring alternate components, but Alice has a clear view of the situation and a jumpstart on her response. The supply chain twin and Pulse provide the foundation of what you need for end-to-end visibility of your supply chain. One consistent view of data across your organization, your partners in the world, delivering alerts, collaborative event management, and AI-driven optimization. Thank you for your time today, and we look forward to bringing intelligence, transparency, and sustainability to your supply chain.
Thank you, Ashwin and Chris, for demonstrating how a digital twin and a supply chain twin really looks like, how people can access this information in an excellent way. As mentioned before, we are not doing that ourselves. We are actually working here with a broad ecosystem. The partner ecosystem consists out of data partners, application partners, and system integrators. We build out this ecosystem and we will extend this ecosystem as we go so that we can provide actually data sets which are relevant for everyone in the supply chain. Finally, I want to thank you for taking the time to listen to this session. I want to thank Dave Ingram for participating and of course the colleagues Ashwin and Chris for demonstrating the solution. Enjoy the show.